My name is Chris Gabriel, and I'm a whale biologist at Glacier Bay National Park, and I monitor underwater sound and work for the humpback whale population monitoring program. A humpback whale is a migratory baleen whale, and that means that it spends part of the year in high latitude waters like Alaska feeding, and then part of the year down in the tropics for the breeding and calving season. And Glacier Bay National Park is in Alaska, and so a lot of humpback whales come to Southeast Alaska to feed each summer. And the humpback whale monitoring program is a system that Glacier Bay National Park uses to find out how many different whales are using the park and where they are. And that's important for a couple reasons. One thing we do with that data is track the population trend over years. This is a very long study. It's long-term monitoring, and it started in 1985. And so we've been able to track the population over that time and determine that the population has grown at about 5 to 7% a year. Well, fortunately for us, the whale tails are like a fingerprint. They're unique individual markings. And so we can tell every single whale from every other whale just by taking a photo of the underside of the tail when they show their tail when they're diving. And so we go out on the water in a small boat, and we find humpback whales and we take pictures of them as they dive. We make notes in the field about what we're seeing, what the whales are feeding on, where they are, and each of those individual photographs and set of notes becomes a record in a large database that we have on humpback whale life histories. And because the whales come back here year after year after year, we have histories of whales that have spent every year of their life so far coming to Glacier Bay in the summer. So Glacier Bay is a really important habitat for whales, and I think it's wonderful that the Park Service is taking such good care of that resource, as well as documenting it and tracking it over time.
And then these little flakes are whale skin.
So we have a really cool way of passively collecting a whale DNA, and that happens when a whale breaches. The whales slough skin, kind of like if you had a sunburn, you slough that skin. Well, whales are sloughing their skin all the time. And so when they breach or slap their tail on the water, we wait for the whale to leave, and then we go over to the slick where that whale was with a little fish net, and we go and pick up a piece of that skin. And that skin is a gold mine of information. You can find out the genetic, basically we get a DNA fingerprint of that animal, but you can also find out more about what the animal has been eating. You can find a little bit about hormone levels. You can find all sorts of things from that piece of tissue. I think that studying humpback whales over the past 30 years so far has had a really strong effect on being able to protect Glacier Bay as whale habitat, as well as an excellent marine ecosystem and a place to visit. And I hope that for the future, I hope that humpback whale monitoring continues long into the future, because it enriches park visitors' experience, as well as teaches us a lot about whale biology.